my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Monday, January 10th, 2011. This is the beginning of FX Bootcamp's first week-long trading marathon of the new year. And this is your New York session video technical briefing for that day, for Monday. A video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback. Please leave a comment when you're done watching this video. Even if you just say hi or thanks, I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day, and we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 3-minute chart without indicators for the Australian dollar US dollar currency pair, as that chart looked at 9:30 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dobook 360 trading platform. Now, the main reason I wanted to show you the price action for this pair on a 3-minute chart, that reason can be seen at the upper left-hand portion. You might notice this relatively sharp dip that I'm now pointing to with a blue arrow. That appears to be the single biggest red 3-minute candle this pair has seen yet today, and it represents the initial reaction about 11 and a half hours ago, the initial reaction to the release of a report which showed that China's trade surplus in December was the lowest seen by that country in 8 months. Again, low trade surplus numbers from China. That news weighed on the commodity currencies, particularly the Aussie, during the latter part of the Asian session trading today and the first half of the European trading day. Now, during today's London lunch session, the Aussie found support at an area defined by three prospective sources of support, all of which we discussed in my live coaching session during London lunch today. Well, I'm talking about the daily M1 pivot point, denoted by the green line at the bottom of the chart, the 55 EMA from its daily chart, represented by this horizontal blue line, and just above that, the bright lime green line that represents the 50% Fibonacci retracement level of the move up this pair made last month from December 1st to December 31st. Now, the recent rise up of roughly 40 pips that you see on the right-hand portion of this chart, that rise there took it up to a combination of the 38.2% Fibonacci retracement level of today's move down. At 38.2% Fib was at about 99.20. We talked about that also during my live coaching session. What was also there at the time, actually just above 99.20, a 21 EMA on the hourly chart. The hourly 21 in combination with a 38.2% Fib. In that context, taking a short trade at or near 99.20 for those reasons was totally reasonable. Now, what was not quite as reasonable, given the downtrend on this pair this pair has made starting early last week, but totally logical given the struggles this pair saw at its daily M1 pivot point and the other support levels earlier, what was still reasonable was to look for a counter trend scalp long trade in a bet that profit taking near the end of the European trading day would push this pair back up to some extent. Let's switch now to a 15-minute chart and move that chart forward in time by just 30 minutes. Looking now on the lower right-hand portion of this 15-minute chart, during the most recent red candle that I'm highlighting in blue here, during that candle, I told the live class that there was potential for formation of a higher low in this area just above 98.90, for two reasons. First, we've seen hesitation by the Aussie around that 50% Fib that I mentioned earlier. We've seen hesitation by the Aussie around that area already. And second, if you conduct a Fib study based on the most recent move up from here to there, you learn that the 78.6% Fib retracement level of that move up is represented here by the horizontal purple line that I'm pointing to now, that line at 98.92. The idea here is that a higher low following a double bottom, here's a double bottom at the daily M1, a higher low following a double bottom would be a likely precursor to a more sustained move up. So, one viable trade plan, if you were thinking up, was to go long at that purple line, give or take a couple of pips. If you took the shot, your entry is somewhere again right around in here. Your stop loss could be initially positioned 50 pips below your entry for catastrophic protection purposes. And your exit strategy could be as simple as closing the trade for a very modest loss if the Aussie were to dip a handful of pips below the horizontal green line, which again represents today's M1 pivot point. 15 minutes later, at the close of this green candle right there, that candle closed just above 99.10. At that point, you're sitting on about 15 pips of profit, making that a very reasonable point at which to move your stop loss to break even. A logical target for this trade was the daily central pivot point, represented by the horizontal black line just in the upper portion of this chart, that black line just below 99.50. The Aussie reached that daily pivot point, that central pivot point, just a little more than 30 minutes after today's London close. London close represented here by the bright red vertical line. If you close a long trade at the central pivot point, in other words, if you close it right in there, you earn just over 50 pips on that long. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Monday, January 10th.